A positive charge Q is uniformly distributed along a circular ring of radius r. A small test charge Q is placed at the center of the ring. Then, so out of the given options, we have to choose which are the correct options. So here we have a charge Q that is placed at the center of the ring. So let's look at the situation of this charge. So in the first option, he is saying that if the charge is positive. So if the charge given is positive and is displaced away from the center in the plane of the ring, where in the plane of the ring, it will be pushed back towards the center. Now consider this ring is made up of very small elements. Clear? Now each element is also positively charged, and this positively charged element will push this charge in this direction. So this element will also exert a force on this charge in this direction, and hence the net force on this charge is zero when it is at the center. Now suppose if I displace this charge from the center to this point. Now as this point is closer to this element, so the force on the charge when placed here in this direction will be more than the force on this charge in this direction, and hence the net force on the charge is towards the center. Similarly, if we consider other elements of the ring, so a similar situation is there, and in each situation the net force will be towards the center of the ring when it is displaced from the center. So it shows that when we move this charge in the plane of the ring, it will be in a stable equilibrium situation. Clear? So this first option is correct. Now in the second option, he is saying that if Q is less than zero, means Q is negative and is displaced away from the center in the plane of the ring, it will never return to the center and will continue moving till it hits the ring. Yes. So if this charge is negative, so consider this element. Clear? So long as this negative charge is placed at the center, net force on the charge is zero. Why? Because when this is a negative charge, so this element will attract this charge in this direction, and this element will attract the charge in this direction, and the net force on the charge is zero. But when we displace this charge from the center, say I displace this charge from the center towards this point. Now when this charge is placed here, the force of attraction by this element will be more than the force by this element. Clear? And this force is, and the net force on this charge is in this direction. Clear? So it will not move towards the center, and it will keep on moving towards the end of the ring. So when we have a negative charge at the center of the ring, so long it is placed at the center of the ring, the net force on it is zero. Clear? But as soon as you displace this charge in this plane, so it will keep on moving in the direction in which you have displaced it. Means it is in unstable situation, unstable equilibrium at this point. Clear? So this second option is also right. Now in option 3, he is saying that if Q is less than 0, it will perform simple harmonic motion for small displacement along the axis. So for this, consider this figure. So this is our ring in the question, and it has a positive charge Q, and this is the center of the ring. Now if I displace the negative charge from the center of the ring along the axis, say up to here, and this separation is say X, so negative charge is now here. Now he is saying that it will perform simple harmonic motion. Now how it will perform simple harmonic motion? For this, look at this formula. We know that the electric field along the axis of a charge ring is equal to K Q divided by R square plus X square 3 by 2 into X. Now he is saying the small displacement, This means x is very much less than r. So for this situation we can write E equal to k q divided by r cube into x. Now the force experienced by this negative charge when placed at a separation x can be written as F, that is equal to q into E. So this is k q divided by r cube into x. And as this charge is negative, so if we put vector sign, so we can write this, that this force will bring this charge towards the center, as this force is in the direction opposite to the direction of displacement. So if you compare this equation, minus kx, clear? So this formula clearly shows that this is an equation of simple harmonic motion, clear? And also physically you can understand it. So if I consider this ring in the form of elements, so this element will attract this charge in this direction, this element will attract this charge in this direction, and the resultant of both the forces will be towards the center. Similarly, when this charge comes to the center, due to inertia it will overshoot the center and it will reach on this side. Again, this element will attract it in this direction, this element will attract it in this direction, and finally resultant is towards the center. So it will keep on oscillating. This means the negative charge when displaced perpendicular to the plane of the ring, it is in stable equilibrium situation. So this option C is also correct. Now in option D he is saying that the Q is at the center of the ring is in an unstable equilibrium within the plane of the ring for Q greater than 0. Now this is wrong. This statement is wrong. If it is written that Q is less than 0, then it's okay that it will be unstable in the plane of the ring, but here it is given that it is Q greater than 0, so this statement is wrong. So out of these four options, we have these three options A, B, C as the correct options.